Time now for the song that changed my life. Our guest, Nick Lowe. Nick Lowe is a power pop singer from just outside London. Cruel to Be Kind, the song you're hearing right now, is probably his biggest hit single. It's really, really catchy. But Lowe is also a master behind the scenes. He's produced and written for so many people. Elvis Costello, Johnny Cash, The Damned, Rod Stewart. This summer and fall, he's reissuing a handful of his records from the middle of his catalog, starting at 1982's Nick the Knife. Like a lot of musicians, Nick can track his love of pop music back to a pretty early age. And for him, it goes back over half a century to when he was growing up on a British airbase in Jordan, listening to his mom's country and western records.
As a child, I lived in Jordan for a period because my dad was in the Royal Air Force. Really, looking back now, it was the end of the British Empire, you know, but there were still some vestiges of the former glory days. Being in the forces, you were never that far from an American radio station as well. You could pick up the American Forces Network as well. And so at that time, the music from the United States couldn't have been any more different to the stuff that we were served up as English kids. The singers were better. It swung harder. It was, I could tell, even at that age. And I was starting to get interested in music then. My mother had a number of long-playing records. This usual stuff that you had back then, Sinatra, Peggy Lee, Doris Day. And for some reason, she also had two 10-inch albums of Tennessee Ernie Ford. Well, I played these over and over again. I loved all of the songs, actually, but the one that really stuck with me was Fatback Louisiana, USA.
They got a song about Cincinnati and Tennessee, but nobody's wrote about the town that's heaven to me.
Tennessee Ernie Ford, I didn't know this then. I just thought he had a very exotic name. These artists had these incredible names, you know, Howling Wolf, you know, I couldn't imagine what this guy looked like. You know, I could hear him, you know, but I couldn't imagine what he looked like. Furlin Husky, you know, I'd never heard of anyone called Furlin Husky. You know, everyone I knew was called Graham and sort of Dennis, and they just sounded so cool.
But they're handy when you're hungry because they're built out of grits.
But the whole track, even to my seven-year-old ears, just swings so hard. It sounded like a kid's song for grown-ups. I'd never heard anything like that. It sounded really sophisticated, but it was clearly fun, and everyone involved in the thing was having a ball. That was a brand new experience to me. Everything's great on it. The groove is so swinging. That drum, you know, the little drum whack, you know, that crops up, Fatback Whack.
In Fatback Louisiana, USA.
That features in another Tennessee Ernie record called Shotgun Boogie. The drum copies the sound of a shotgun, and it was such a success, they decided to use it in as many songs as they could.
You're gonna get a ham gravy that'll curl your hair. They pour a quart of brandy over a ham and add a pint of gin and let it simmer.
The lyric as well, to my seven-year-old ears, might as well have been in Urdu for all I understood it. I couldn't make head or tail of it. And I occasionally I'd catch a line, like I loved the line about, listen, boys, when you're ill, you get a black-eyed pea instead of a pill.
And listen, boy, when you're ill, you get a black-eyed pea instead of a pill.
And I like the thing about pouring a bottle of brandy and gin over a ham.
In the pan, then they drink up all the juice and throw the ham away in Fatback Louisiana.
I didn't know what grits were or any of these. I knew it was about food. I knew the whole thing was about food, but it was kind of food that I'd never heard of. I've always liked humour in lyrics, especially when it's allied with a serious musical approach. The contradiction has always interested me, and Tennessee Ernie always, he had that going in spades, really. My relationship to this song has changed in one respect, that I like it even more than I did when I was seven. This song was the nearest I heard to rock and roll at that time. It opened the door for what came next: Little Richard, Jerry Lee Lewis, Elvis Presley. This song preceded it. It totally opened the door for me. And when I first heard it, it seemed to make complete sense, even though I didn't know what he was talking about.
Back, Louisiana, USA.
Nick Lowe, on the song that changed his life, Fatback Louisiana, USA, by Tennessee Ernie Ford. Nick's label, Yep Rock Records, is re-releasing a bunch of his albums this summer and fall. We'll have a link for you to buy them on the Bullseye page at MaximumFun.org.